master. What I'm looking for is the gable. I'm looking for underneath these eaves. I want to take pictures from right here for several reasons. I'm looking for how the corner is. I'm looking for the depth of that valley metal, how far it sticks out. I'm looking for the way that their hip ridges terminate at the ends, like how are those collected, how many stacks of tile are there. I make sure I've got pictures of every linear feet of under every eave, especially at corners, any kind of transitions, any kind of hip ridges that come down and terminate, any kind of flashings, like up there in a corner. I want to get pictures of these little turnouts right here, and I want to see how are they integrated with the stucco. Any kind of strange joggle transitions like that, and just get pictures of the way they are, so that after our detach and reset, if we were to have done one at this house or going to be doing one, I have all of this data at one time. And then I would just go around the back of the house. Same thing is happening back there. I am just simply taking details. The way things are, electric box. I take pictures of the gates, any kind of entrances like this. AC units, what's going on behind them. I take pictures of any kind of access ways. Now this house is closed in, so there's stucco, but in most homes you have an eave like this, for instance, that's open. So I'd be looking for any kind of water damage, damaged wood, anything like that. That's gonna alert me where to go on top of the roof once I get up there. Back here, I'm taking overall shots of the whole back area. What's back here, bushes, sensitive items, vases, plants, things that could break if one of these tiles falls down. You know, I wanna know what was here or what's not here. Anytime I see a covering, I always wanna come back. I wanna get shots of this roof system. This is gonna tell me if there's any leaks on this back slope. It's going to end up here somehow or another. So that again alerts me to something I may or may not need to pay attention to. As I come back around to the rest of the house, I'm looking for my angles again. So I'm going to come back to these back walls. Obviously I'm holding my camera horizontal right now, but in situations like this where, you know, work with the topography and what you're trying to take a picture of. If something like this, hold your phone straight up and down into portrait mode. If you've got wide shots you're trying to do, hold your phone sideways and take pictures that way. Use your camera the way that the scene needs to be captured. That about does the backyard. Let's move up to the top now. Okay, here we go. Tile inspection. I've already gone around the undersides perimeter of the house on ground level. When I come up off the ground, first thing I do is I go to my highest ridges and I start taking my overheads. I want to get my overall orientation of the roof for our company cam. So that's going to be for production purposes, for later purposes when comms or when virtual project managers are trying to communicate with our teams, that we have a wherewithal for the whole roof and we can understand what we're all talking about. So because this roof is unusually cut up, there's a lot of features on it. So there's a lot of things to get independent pictures of. So like we have this whole outcropping right here of various different hip ridge. So I wanna get details. I would get a photo from here. I would get a photo right here where this whole transition is happening in this valley. I wanna see what's going on there from every angle. What I'm paying attention to for later is how do these tiles actually meet up? Like how wide were they? How close are they? Because we're gonna detach and we're gonna reset this roof. So these kind of pictures are very key for that process. So once I've got pictures of all the angles from the tops of everything, the next thing I do is my measurements. I'll run around, I'll get measurements of all of the penetrations, all the fixtures, and I put all that into a sequence. And what I do after that is my actual inspection. So I'm gonna start all the way on the furthest end away from my ladder, and I'm gonna work my way backwards. So I would start with this gable right over here, both of these facets. I would take samples high, low. What I'm looking for is I would probably take four, maybe five samples, an extra one right here in the valley. The valley, we always expect to see the worst damage, but I always want to get control samples, I call them, because I want to show my clients what healthy underlayment looks like. And so then I'd work my way back, same process. I'm going high, low, high, low, high, low, a couple in my valleys so I can get that juxtaposition of things and show that's obviously where all the problems are always, almost always are. As I'm moving through this, I'm also checking for the ridges. Are they secure? So these are loose, as you can see here. We would move back facet by facet, taking high-low samples. As I'm moving back, I'm looking around any kind of fixtures like this. I'm gonna be paying attention to flashings. All of my mortar caps, all of the weather guard, is everything in place? Those are the things that I'd be paying attention to. So a little tile awareness. As you're walking on these, we always walk on the lower third. So as these overlap, it's basically right here is the strongest part of the tile. So we try and avoid stepping on this. We always avoid, we step over valleys of any kind. So when you're walking, we always just step over. We always step over ridges of all types. So never step on a ridge tile. That's just some basics of moving around a roof. And here we go. So I always start up high. We look in. It's really bright outside, so I really can't see what I'm looking at. This is normally how it is. So what I'm doing is I'm lifting just this corner of the tile, and I just stick my phone right under there, snap a picture, and then sort it out afterwards in the shade. What I'm looking for is seams. You know, our underlayment's 3 feet wide. So what happens is there's underlayment that goes over the whole ridge, but that's after the fact. So you have a first layer of underlayment starting here, coming down roughly 3 feet. So usually the third tile down is where you're gonna catch a seam, and you're gonna be able to tell the condition of that seam. And then obviously the condition of the underlayment itself. So notice how I'm stepping. I step with the balls of my feet, and I just step near the bottom. So I kind of tippy toe around the roof most of the time. A little bit to the outside. Water likes to travel in a triangle motion around things. So I always look around fixtures. I always take pictures of where trees are overlapping a roof. This one looks good. Nothing's touching. That's what we want to see. Perfect example of what happens when somebody doesn't stay away from valleys. So let's see what's going on here. Oh, see here, this is what we're talking about. So you see how in a valley, it starts to degrade that pump, that pressure right where the wooden batten is. Look at this. This is leaking right here. Okay, next thing we do, we pull out a tile. First thing we do is stick a tape on it, get our overall measurement. We get our width measurement, and then take note, I'll get a picture right over here over the top. What that picture is for is how many nail holes do we have for fasteners. I'll get a picture alongside like this, and this tells me the groove. Sometimes I'll take it down like that so I can actually see this. We wanna make sure that any replacement tiles that we get fits perfectly. I'll get a picture of the manufacturer, any other markings on the tile. I get a picture this way, so I run my tape this way because sometimes we have to use tiles that are very, very close, but so we wanna make sure all these nubs, they all are part of the fitting. So some tiles have 3 lines, 2 lines, 1 line, they all have different measurements from each other. So by holding a tape over the whole thing like this, I can get all of those measurements all the way down, or anybody can that needs to, and one across. So that's how that works. Then the next thing I'll do is go do my pipe jack. So it starts right here. So we've got 1, 2, 3, all the same size. And do we have any over here? Oh, yep, 2 more. Oh wow, we got 2 more. Boom, we will snap this, bam. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Next thing is O'Hagan vents. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4. There's always a high and low. So on every slope, if you're standing somewhere and you see a high O'Hagan, there's a low O'Hagan. So you've got an inlet and an exhaust on every slope. So in this situation, see, they're using the low one right there and then the high one's right here. That's sharing an attic space. So on the other side, there's gonna be another low one right there and another high one. So we've got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 26, 28, 30, 32, and there is 2 over there, 34. 34 O'Hagans. All right, got our measurements. Okay, so something else I do whenever I'm inspecting a house that I notice doesn't have solar is I will come and take pictures of their electric box so that we can know if they're a good candidate for it or not. Pictures of this, open this, pictures of that, any labels, pictures of that, and a back over wide picture of the whole setup so they can tell how many amps are available and what's all there. Not everybody likes to save money with solar, but you know, for those that do, our inspections will be ready.